All right, guys, we're back, and I have since, I think I managed to actually resolve the issue. I'm hoping it's a theory. God, why am I always so tempted to say, make that dumb game theory joke? Anyway, so what I did was, I think what's going on was, there's an issue with wattage going into the TV. I think what it is, so a crock pot was definitely turned on in the kitchen. So I think that there was a conflict with how much wattage the TV was getting, since the power was going through a power strip. So what I did was I just took the cable and plugged it in directly into a power socket. So hopefully the TV does no longer do the power thing, and hopefully we're able to keep the shit going, because that's the only time I ever had to deal with that. Anyway, so before we go on, I actually want to show some stuff off really fast. First of all, it's scary how close I am to actually having goddamn burps, how close I am to being maxed on ninja points, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jump in here and see what we got. I don't think a lot of points have been attained since last time, but still worth the little guy anyway to see what we got. Naruto versus Sasuke photo, okay. I will eventually look at those, because those are like little albums that are completely re-narrated, so that might be worth looking at the very end of this, maybe. Assuming I do get all of them, which, I tell you, if I somehow don't have 12,700 ninja points by the time I'm done with Hidden Mugenjo, I will be shocked. Like, holy shit. In worst case scenario, if I don't have enough of it, I'll just grind until I do. Alright, that wasn't a terrible amount. But, remember that as you go through, as you go through Mugenjo mode, the amount of ninja points, like the average, slowly increases. So by the time you're done with it, you're going to be getting like probably 50 ninja points per fight you do. So yeah, don't disparage, you'll probably have enough of it by the end anyway. And before we move on, I also want to show off the thing and with the backgrounds. As soon as we load this. Okay. View photos. Nope, that's not it. Oh, this is the thing I'll be looking at later. I do have the Naruto versus Sausage one. That's pretty cool. Alright, that's not it. It was the images, but it was like way down at the bottom. Yeah, so like you got story mode cutscenes that you can view. Pretty cool stuff. Yes, Naruto uses the Rasengan. Holy shit. All the secrets. Yeah, you get these that you can just freely view. Actually, I feel like this is a really fucking good render that was actually had a good amount of effort put into it. That said, Naruto's eyes are a little lopsided, but you know, whatever. Is he also have two climbing rooms? Yeah, here you go. These are the backgrounds you get, so. That's just me. I think that's pretty good. Alright, damn. There's a bunch of. I think some of these are concept art, too. Oh, Jesus. The default view for that is so fucking pixel. That's not the capture. That's, like, legit. That is tessellated as hell. There we go. That's what I better look at. Alright, it's funny how we do have new renders for Orochimaru, but, like, the story mode uses the old ones from Ultra Ninja 1. That's so weird, I don't get that, but, alright, sure, what the fuck ever. Alright, floor 76, I guess I should be glad that those problems were rising halfway through recording, so I can get it resolved. And with that, let us continue this bullshit. Okay, so it looks like we have two treasure rooms, both are pretty easy to get. What I'll do is first I'll get these two middle ones, get the treasure rooms, and then I'll get the healing room, then I'll continue. So, yeah, that sounds like a bit of a game plan. Also, I'm pretty sure at this point they're just kind of recycling a lot of the tree climbing map layouts. Pretty fucking concerned about that, actually. Alright. It always gives you the three to start, too. I don't remember it originally doing that, but alright. Here. Whew, all right, this feels a lot smoother. All right, with any luck, maybe my idea is going to work with the TV power thing, so hopefully this should not cut on me whatsoever. Here's hoping. Otherwise, I don't know, might have to use that warranty anyway. All right, come over here. Nope. Damn, my inputs even feel sharper too. Oops. Oh, come on. I was off by a fucking pixel from getting that perfectly. Oh, fuck. Okay.
1560.
I love how you bump into one thing and your run's entirely fucked up.
I love that.
Alright, that's one. Probably shouldn't go for two street climbing ones in a row, but... Yeah, I know, we're not doing that. We're going for another amusement room. If I keep getting tree climbing ones, I'm eventually going to have to do the shuffle on these things. Alright. You know where to drill with these by now. If you gamble and win, you get tokens. If you gamble and lose, well, you're getting out of here faster anyway, so nothing matters. Actually, I've been meaning to talk... I've got to talk about it sooner. I'm surprised that... the first 60 floors only took 12 parts to get through. Like, I've been... making sure to be pretty, liberal with, getting a decent amount of footage into every part. Otherwise, the playthrough would probably be over, like, 30 parts. Not quite BT2 level, but, damn it, I didn't want to go in here yet. Oops. Reflex. God damn it. Yeah, we're good. Anyway, what was I saying? Fuck. Yeah, not quite BT2 levels of how long this Let's Play would take, but it's certainly up there for a Naruto Let's Play. I mean, I say that, but Ultimate Ninja 1 did take a good while to complete. 2 took some time to complete. I want you guys to realize that once I publish a video, I never look back to it unless, like, I'm particularly proud of it. And, I don't know, the original Ultimate Ninja Trilogy, I feel like I probably could have done better on. Because there was a number of factors that went into holding those videos back a little bit, like the equipment, not being correct, losing 2 hours of footage of the first game, and having that delayed. There was a lot of problems with the first Ultimate Ninja Let's Play I did, but that's in the past, and there are still some Let's Plays I consider redoing. Chief among them, of course, being Clash Ninja Revolution. I don't know if I should, because, like, that's a legacy game right there, like... Someone else popular Let's Play, so I don't know. That does tell me I should probably do more, like, something else with this series, though. Alright. Oh, man, edge that one out. Still bites you don't have One Tail Naruto regularly playable, but you know what? Fuck it, it's fine. Alright. Just laying. Oh, fuck, okay. Yeah, like, I want to see Kakashi do that fucking move. Naruto, his clone wasn't even doing the right thing. Fuck. Oh yeah, that's right, you lose all your chakra once it runs out. Just throw her, fuck it. Whoa, was that uppercut based off of the hook he delivered to Neji's chin? I wonder about that. It looks awfully similar to it, but I don't know, that must be a coincidence. Anyway, hey, another amusement room, why not? Yeah, no, you can definitely tell it was Tsunade that gave us these scrolls, because one of them is straight up gambling. Definitely not a little suspicious. And I got triple sevens right off the bat, okay. Gambling, that's a script of the course, but you know what, it's fine. Because I'm not a crazy man, I'm not gonna stay here and keep gambling, because that would be a waste of time. And I specifically only use amusement rooms so I can get through this game faster. Okay, moving on. Treasure room in the middle? Question mark? This is an interesting layout. Okay, so I could take the straight three bottom paths, or the straight three rooms down the bottom, and get to the exit. I could take the one at the bottom, go left, right, hit the treasure room, break the rocks, and go and do two. That's still a three path, and a two path for the treasure room thrown in, but the two path is going to require multiple skills in order to get through. Boy, I don't know how much I like that. Whereas if you were to take the long way around, you would have to go 1, 2, 3, and then you reach a treasure room, and then 4, 5, 6 in order to leave. You know what? What we're gonna do, tree climbing room, we're just gonna do the one from the side, use Byakugan, get through that way, come back, and then keep going south. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna keep this shit easy. No complicated stuff. Not too complicated anyway. Alright, just throwing us right in. I can't but wonder, like, what the lower difficulties for this mode is. I've just been playing this, like, the hard ones for so long, but getting blindsided by stumps all the time that I just, I kind of forget what happens when you just take this game mode casually, you know? Then again, when you play Doom regularly, this is, like, pretty much slow motion. It's just probably something about the TV just fucked up my eyes with this. Wait. 4 milliseconds off of a perfect. God damn it, Apple. I shouldn't be grabbing too much, but it should also really bump you up to the full bonus, but, you know, whatever. Okay, so, yeah, Parasitic Jutsu. Yeah, just cut through the side. Because I'm pretty sure this treasure room might have something decent. Maybe. If it has to, if you had to go through that much work. Bingo! Resist scroll. Still don't really know what that means. I still don't think it means, like, yeah, resist room. That, it would probably mean, like, resistance to ninjutsu or ultimate jutsus, but I have no proof of that, so I don't know. Assuming anyone is still watching this Let's Play at this point, because it is fairly arduous, even for me, to be playing this game. Like, what does resist specifically mean? Because I have a working theory of what it might mean, but I don't want to invest enough in it and experiment enough with it to, like, figure it out. Probably because I take a lot of effort, and effort's not the thing I'm willing to put out right now. I mean, I could just Google it, but, you know. My hands are occupied with a controller and stuff. Well, mainly a console, but, you know, whatever. Alright, you know, why not? I haven't done a shout-out position in a while. I have been ignoring Shikamaru's JoJo poses, so I might as well go ahead and do it. I mean, if the man's able to, like, fucking do a push-up or hold himself up off the ground with just a hand, I think that warrants my attention. You're going for a vibe, huh? He's doing a slop squat! Oh shit, Shikamaru did a slop squat. Circle, triangle, up, down, down. There we go. I should have lingered on the slop squat, damn it. Ow. Going for six already, holy shit. And you can do splits also. Square, X, triangle, X, left, X. Damn. Okay, was it X then left? I don't remember. Alright. I'm so taken aback by these fucking poses he's doing. Boom, 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 boom. Okay. I have been playing this game for a long fucking time. But I have not seen some of those poses. Holy shit. Like, I didn't know Shikamaru does slob squats. Apparently. Fucking slobaboo. Alright. You're damn right I just used that term. Alright. 479. Go for riddles? Okay. Hang on. What are we doing here? Yeah, let's take the easier route. Okay. I'm just gonna do the two here. Take the rocks out of the bottom. And then we're out. Bada bing, bada boom. Easy. Alright. I don't know why I keep saying that. Like, I don't know. What does Shino do for a hobby? Collect sunglasses? I mean, it's possible. If we're talking about known hobbies, and yeah, who did soccer and sunrider to get stronger? Definitely Orochimaru, definitely. Alright then. And last one, what Jutsu awakens the Shukaku that sleeps inside? I still wanted to be Sawing Log Jutsu. I would pay good money for Gaara to say Sawing Logs Jutsu or Nap Jutsu. That would just be too good. Maybe, just maybe, Liam O'Brien would come to Arizona at some point and we can get him to say that. Who knows? Who knows? Alrighty, so Kisame again. You know what? Neji and Lee do fight Kisame in Shippuden. That's not fun, why not? Or I could chose Neji and have it chakra depletion versus chakra depletion. That would have been fun too. Maybe not. Alright. Woo! Just jumping right in. The only issue with... Oh shit, he's got shark bombs. You saw me with shark bombs, you don't say, Bob. Holy fuck. Okay. Oh, fuck. There we go. I should know how to fight Kisame decently. He was like pretty much the character I used the most in Heroes 1 because he was so fucking brain dead. Oh, that's easy. That's an interesting throw. Did you ever use that throw in the show? I have no idea. Dang, I know the ninja, despite its oversimplicity sometimes, it does take a lot of really good cues from the show. Oh fuck. Without reach? It's weird he doesn't, like, make an approach with dynamic entry, but whatever. Go for it! Ah, okay. This Kisame is... And I slid off! Oh, okay. Ooh, okay. Nope. Fuck. Shark skin bad. Make big ouchies out. Alright, there we go. Finally connected. I didn't have to land it in order to win, but I just kind of felt like it. Boom! Okay. So, with that taken care of, I think we can continue. Where the hell was I at anyway? I think I'm on like, what, floor 80 or something like that? Oh yeah, that's right, don't forget you get bonus points for winning using an ultimate jutsu, so that's always pretty good. Yeah, I can slice you rock! Okay. 80th floor, damn, we're making good progress. Okay, now, let's just go ahead and mix things up a little bit. Swear, this does not sound like, that sounds more like Jameson Price than it does, fuck, I almost forgot his name, damn it. Okay, whatever, Riddle Room, let's go for that. Riddle Fly Me. Whatever that means. Uh-huh. What we got here? What is Eno's last name? That's an easy one. If you own them by now, there's an issue. Alright, which of these ninjas specializes in medical ninjutsu? Again, technically all the... Well, actually no, Neji doesn't. You can also make an argument over what college actually specializes in, but you know. Neji does the Third Hokage summon. Ooh, Enma, I think, right? I'm pretty certain. Yeah.
Oh, you answered.
I seriously had to contemplate that for a sec because... Okay, if you're a manga reader like I am, then you're probably not used to seeing Hashirama doing anything beyond his initial fight against Orochimaru. You can't. Yeah. The time has come, and so have I.
This time I will eliminate you without fail.
Okay, Kasumi, real talk, you suck. You fucking stuck Itachi on me, but that didn't work. Are you certain you can do that?
Huh? She looks different than before.
Sorta? Princess. We are making direct threats now. There's definitely a bit of conflict going on here. Oh no! Oh no, myself!
Hey, there's no time to argue.
No, Kasumi. Oh wait, no. No, I think Kasumi would know about Kurama inside Naruto, wouldn't she? Because I think Naruto maintains that memory of using the chakra. Oh boy,